guillotine.
Who done?
This all started when Aldo from No Art, who is mostly known for his in-depth animations on Instagram and YouTube, reached out to me in November and he told me that he wanted to make a video about why guillotine blades are angled. We always assumed that this was the best shape, but is it really and why? So he asked me if I could help him out, if I had some suggestions, and I thought, well, maybe watermelon, that kind of stuff. Funny thing is that he forgot to mention that he wanted to do it on a small scale, and I was like, bro wants a guillotine, bro gets a guillotine. Aldo and I discussed the design and execution plan, and my objective for this project is doing the engineering, making sure that it works in a safe way, and his objective is the actual findings of the test themselves. I've been working on and off for the last couple of months on this project, keeping close contact with Aldo, and one day Aldo randomly mentioned that they had a big old tree trunk which was infested with woodworm, which was perfect for this project, and that he happens to have a sawmill. So I was like, maybe we should film this. I already received the blades that I ordered, which were in the background of my previous video, by the way, and haven't opened the package yet. We decided to open the package together to see how they look, so I dragged them out of the basement. They were pretty heavy and threw them in the back of the car. The next day I went to his place to start making the beams. Once there, I was surprised by the size and beauty of the location. This couldn't be more perfect for this project. We dragged the heavy oak trunk to the sawmill, placed it on there, and discussed the needed dimensions based off of my preliminary design. Once everything was clear, we fired up that sawmill and started making the beams. Eventually, we loaded everything in the trailer and the beams looked great. What I haven't mentioned yet is that besides the straight and angled blades, I made two, let's call them bonus blades. I will tell you a bit more about the types of blades we have later on. We stored the beams somewhere in the field so we could pick them up when I'm there again for the actual build. The sun was setting and we had some time left to grind a notch on that first blade. I really wanted to test this. Don't try this at home, kids. I just wanted to see if it could hold an edge. And it did. So we had our wood and the blades, so I could finalize the design. Or so I thought. We were starting to doubt that angled blade. I made that angled blade, so the standard blade, at an angle of 30 degrees. Which to me looked good based off of the pictures that I found on Google. But Aldo found a different example from a guillotine that was at the Prison Gate Museum in The Hague that seemed to have an angle of 45 degrees. Long story short, we decided to visit them before making the final design. Even better, Aldo played the YouTuber card and we were allowed to go to the museum's archives to do measurements on a real guillotine blade, which was pretty awesome. The blade looked different than expected, but we were able to do some meaningful measurements to it. After that, we checked some of the other cool stuff they had and appreciated the engineering that went into these torch devices. Then we went to the actual museum to see the real thing. The guillotine was in this glass box, unfortunately. This was done so it could be preserved better. We were able to check it out and do some more measurements, and it looked like my initial design wasn't that bad.
61.
So a special thanks to the Prison Gate Museum in The Hague. And if you happen to be in The Hague, then definitely give them a visit. Once back home, I modified the design so it fits the beams that we made earlier that were thicker than the ones I initially designed for. I also designed the new blade with a 45 degree angle and had to remove some material to make it the same weight as the others. Let's just ignore this big red print on my desk that absolutely doesn't contain any design flaw. I redesigned that part, which is part of the carriage that uses skateboard wheels to move smoothly along the vertical beams, and started the print on the Prusa XL. While that was printing, I designed a holder for my old rocked cat phone that we are going to use to do some measurements. The plan is to use a G-sensor, so we can hopefully measure the performance difference between the blade shapes. The phone literally fitted the first time, and I was pretty pleased with that considering its difficult shape. Also, the carriage part was correct now, and I was able to mount the wheels to it. I did a quick test and things are looking good. Thing is though, that these parts must be strong and big. We are going to drop a steel blade from several meters high to a dead stop. So I needed quite a lot of quality filament that has high impact strength, prints reliably and fast. Well, here is where the sponsor of this video comes in. Voxel PLA, which is the perfect fit for this project. Before starting the rest of the prints, I added the Hoola anti-vibration dampeners to my printers that Voxel PLA also offers. It was an easy install and helps increase the quality of the prints, especially at high speeds. Another advantage is that it adds more space below the printer so you can store extra build plates there. I printed the biggest part on the Bamboo Lab because I fitted that with the 0.6mm nozzle. This print required 1.4 kilos, so almost 1.5 spools of filament, and I needed to print two of them. Fortunately, the AMS system has this filament backup feature that selects the next spool when the filament runs out. I just had enough green filament to print the two corner pieces, so I was happy to read that Voxel PLA is the most reliable filament on earth. The PLA Plus and PETG Plus are high-speed filaments that work on those high-speed printers. I printed the second carriage part on the Prusa XL, some top parts on the Prusa MK4, and the rest of the corner pieces on the Creality K1. They sent the colors I used for my branding, and it was nice to use a different color for each group of parts. And yes, the colors look nice and are very vivid. So if you need good looking, high performance filament that prints reliably and is also very affordable, then look no further. Filaments start at $16.99, go as low as $14.99 with bulk discount, and you get free shipping when you purchase three or more spools. So check out the link in the description of this video, and thanks Voxel PLA for sponsoring this project. The top parts were finished and I mounted the pulleys to them while the other big parts were still being printed. These top parts I used to pull up the blade on the guillotine. Then I went back to the basement again and got more parts. One of them was the second carriage part that I mounted together. I was happy to see that the AMS had switched to the next spool, so that was a relief. Eventually, I ended up with one of the biggest parts I ever printed.
The parts were printed with a lot of support material. And you know what that means?
Support removal ASMR.
Yeah,
In this segment, I show you how you can fuck up a perfectly fine piece of wood. I cut it out roughly with this jigsaw and had good faith that my 55-watt CO2 laser cutter from Ixtel would do the job. After several passes at full blast for more than half an hour, almost burning the whole place down, I was pretty confident that it went through, or at least close. And I expected that carving it with a knife on one side so it wouldn't splinter, making some cuts and whacking it with a hammer would do the trick. Well, it wasn't even close. I had to manually cut it with a jigsaw, and that laser cut was just a guideline. At some points it wasn't even a third way through, so this apparently isn't the best wood for laser cutting. The next day I took it to my shed and sanded it down to make it look less shitty. I placed it on my highly advanced state-of-the-art professional milling machine to drill out the holes extremely accurately. I hammered in the threaded nuts for the phone holder and the big bolts that will hold the blades. By the way, this screwdriver I'm using was sent to me by Matmo. They are partially sponsoring this project and sent what I honestly think is the best looking screwdriver I've ever seen. And they also have this pocket-sized screwdriver. I often get comments with questions about the tools that I'm using for making my projects. I can literally fill a whole video with the stuff that I'm using for my projects, but I made it a dedicated webpage where you can find everything. So for instance, this cat mouse from 3D Connection. If you use my link, then you get 10% off of their products. So yeah, there's that. I assembled the rest of the carriage and mounted the new blade that had just arrived. This thing is looking epic. I packed all the parts, drove to Aldo again, and the epic guillotine build can begin. We loaded the beams and drove them to the workshop. Decided to do the most tedious and boring work first, which was grinding the rest of the blades. The material I chose for these blades is a Rayax 400, which is very abrasion resistant steel, and this is what we found out firsthand. I destroyed one angle grinder in the process, and this took us almost a whole day to finish. People with more knowledge about types of metal will probably shake their head and say that this is the most stupid material to make blades out of. This brings a whole different meaning to keep grinding as a YouTuber. Also decided to make the guillotine even taller with the extra wood we had left. This would result in a drop much higher than a regular guillotine, which gave us some headroom and would be extra epic. We left it to dry overnight, and the next day we discussed the drawings I made for the beams so we could start cutting them. After we cut everything, we drilled the holes. The drill didn't go all the way through, but was good enough as a pilot hole. We had to be creative with some holes, and all parts ended up nicely. We loaded everything up and went to the spot where we are going to build this machine of death, scientific project. We grabbed the 3D printed parts out of my car, placed everything on the table, and I proudly showed my big print to Aldo.
Ja, dus hopelijk kan ik deze dan gewoon op die Jezus. Het had ook niet veel. Misschien moeten we dit even met z'n tweeën doen.
Well, this was a good moment to test the impact strength of the Voxel PLA material. Eventually, Aldo used a planer to make it fit. I can tell you, even if these 3D printed parts look redundant and it could have been done without, this made the build much easier and a lot of fun. We'll be right back.
Jezus, man.
The following day, Aldo moved the guillotine to its spot and made sure that it was standing level.
Right.
We used barrier tape to add more scientific flavor to this project. And I mounted the camera to the top of this guillotine for an epic top-down view. We tested the guillotine itself by hoisting the blade to its highest position. This is dropping a 10 kilogram weight with a sharp edge from more than 2 meters high. It will probably cut through the watermelon, but my biggest fear was if the guillotine itself would stay intact.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's smooth, jongen. Wow.
Oh, daar is hij al.
Ja, daar komt hij.
Hij komt best wel snel.
Ja. Dat vind ik echt smooth, jongen. Wauw.
Okay, let me quickly thank my Patreon supporters. Especially my top tier Patreon supporters and gold members. Your support makes these projects possible.
Okay, nou.
Matjes.
Nu gaan we gewoon matjes doen, toch?
Ja. Ja, wel lekker dit.
Aldo bought these mats with the idea to have something consistent to cut. He rolled them into each other to make thicker rolls so we can find the cutting capacity of each blade.
Oh ja, even wegen. 9,9. Nou, we kunnen rustig stellen dat dit 10 kilo is.
Hop.
Dit is nu eentje, toch?
Dit is eentje, ja.
Ja.
We started with one.
Dit al in slow motion of gewoon naar beneden pleuren? En,
gewoon naar beneden pleuren, denk ik toch?
Oh, wow.
It just went through it like butter.
Dit is echt een clean cut, jongen.
Clean.
Oh, shit.
Holy shit, this is really clean.
Sportdata. Nou, even de guillotine aan mijn laptop aansluiten.
It was a sentence I never expected to say in my life. I got the G-sensor data from the guillotine. However, the data is clipping badly, so I'm not sure if this will be useful for Aldo. Then we tested two mats.
Ook gewoon, kijk clean, gewoon, fuck, dat is
een. Jongen,
shit, zeg.
Nou, moet die dikker.
Even kijken, ja, kijk.
Zo. En dit is gewoon het, naar verwachting, dus gewoon het minst heftige mes, hè?
Ja.
Drie stuks. Gaat hij gewoon clean erin, hoor. Hoppa.
Dit zijn vier. Ja. Nog steeds gewoon.
5 mats. And finally 6 mats. We were running out of mats.
Ja, probleemloos.
Your team worked a bit too well.
Oh ja, ik weet het. Het is gewoon een andere manier van meten. We kijken hoe hoog het mes nodig heeft om door deze stapel te komen. En de betere messen kunnen van lager.
Jezus, wat ben jij slim, hè?
Fortunately, Aldo came with an idea for a different approach.
Okay, dan moeten we gewoon even met de meetlint erbij.
By the way, if you're interested in the actual results and the idea behind this, then definitely check out Aldo's video after you've seen this one.
Is het maar 1 meter gewoon? Ja, nee, meter komt hij sowieso niet door.
Nee, ik wou ook even meten hoe hoog dit nou daadwerkelijk is.
Ja, hij heeft een magneetje. Zo, dat is handig.
Chill.
2,15. Ik denk dat de rolmaat ook wel leuk is om eronder te leggen. Oh, dit is echt een mooie shot, joh. Jezus.
Oké, okay, let's go.
Daar pleurt hij hem ook gewoon prima doorheen, hè?
Shit, zeg. 1 meter?
Oké. Okay.
Oké. Okay.
Doe maar op. Op.
Yes.
Hey.
Hey.
Finally, we found a point where the blade didn't cut through.
Even kijken hoe het er op de slow-mo uitziet.
En go.
Science, bitch. Yes.
Yes, we zijn data aan het maken.
Nice.
Hoi.
Je wilt zien? Het is wel vet, hoor.
Ja, is het goed? Ja, ja, hij ging omhoog, het. Maar ja. Hij was er al af. Ja.
Hè?
Hoe dan?
Wij verwachten dat hij nu...
Dat hij er precies of precies net niet doorheen gaat.
Oké, dit is dus het grensgevalletje.
Ja.
Oké, ik heb hem scherp. Ja.
Oké.
Okay, we found the right height for this blade.
Net niet.
Zo. Ja, dan hadden we hem ook geen 2,5 meter hoog hoeven maken. Okay, while Aldo is replacing the blade, I'm going to show you quickly around our setup. We've got a high-speed-ish camera here, shooting at 240 frames a second. We have this blade replacement system. And now we're going from the straight edge to the 30-degree angle. We have this weight here. It is a weight, but also skill. With this, it's easier to... the rope will go back down with this, but we can also measure the total weight of the whole carriage. We found the point where the straight blade just cuts through these mats. So we expect that the straight edge is performing the worst. And we have the angled blade right now in the guillotine at an angle of 30 degrees, which we expect will do better. We have one 45 degrees. That's the one that has the same angle as the one we've seen in The Hague. And we have two, how would you call it, bonus blades. One, the pointy one, and the brachistochrone. I expect that this one is going to perform best, the pointy one.
That's boring. I will go for the 45.
The 45?
Yeah.
Not the brachistochrone?
No.
I hope the brachistochrone will
I hope so too, but I don't think so.
So I'm wondering why in the early days, why they didn't use pointy one. But maybe we will find out during our experiment.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, it would be nice if it's obviously stupid to have this pointy one. Yeah.
All right, Hattie, and...
That is interesting, eh?
Okay, we dropped that angled blade from the same height as the straight blade, and it didn't cut through.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is echt rete interessant, eh?
Also from an even greater height it didn't cut through.
Dit had ik echt
almost.
Niet... Wauw. Even wegen hoeveel die meet hoeveel die weegt. Voordat mensen allemaal gaan zeggen, ja, deze is veel lichter. Straks is hij ook veel lichter.
Ja,
ja. We gaan er nu vanuit dat ze allemaal hetzelfde zijn. Maar...
We measured the weight of the carriage to see if it was significantly lighter. What else could it be?
9,6.
Oh, hij is iets lichter.
Ja, hij is iets lichter.
Ja.
Helemaal goed. Ah, we hebben weer nog genoeg tape. Hoppakee. Drie, twee, één.
Okay, that didn't make any difference.
Het enige wat ik me voor kan stellen wat het kan zijn... is dat die gaat knaaien terwijl die valt.
Ja, nou, dat zouden we op de high speed zouden moeten kunnen zien.
Ja, want als je kijkt naar echte guillotine, die zou dan ook moeten knaaien. Want
we could see that it was tilting. Yeah. And I came to the conclusion that the print itself was interfering with the wooden beam. This could result in a poor performance. Therefore, I suggested removing some material so the only thing in touch with the beams are those wheels.
Yeah. Nice.
Precies.
Oh, dit is geweldig.
That seemed to do the trick.
Nou, die hoeven we niet nog een keer te proberen.
Nee,
dit
nee.
Was precies. Yes.
We found the right height for the angled blade and switched to the blade with the steeper 45 degree angle and dropped that from the same height.
Huh. Wat? Dus hoe...
Het is zo bizar.
Hoe stijler het mes, hoe meer moeite die ermee heeft. Oké. Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Ja, precies. Je hoorde hem niet klappen.
Nee.
Een soort van, hij was echt...
Then we switched to my personal favorite, the pointy one. Well, secretly, the Bacristo Crone is my favorite. Okay, don't drop this.
Nou, gaat hij. 3, 2, 1. Jezus, hé. Ook nee. Gewoon... Kom niet eens in de buurt.
Crazy.
Hoe kan die vlakken nou zoveel beter gaan? Zo, til ik hem even op.
I really didn't understand what was happening. Until I found out that it was lodged in there.
Wat zit dat ding vast, joh? 3, 2, 1.
What the fuck?
Ja, hij kantelt.
Let's go.
1, 2. Ja, dit is hem ook, hè? Hij zou misschien net iets minder hoog nog.
3, 2, 1.
I'm happy that we gave this blade a second chance.
Oké, je hebt hem, de Crystal Crown.
De Crystal Crown time. Ja.
Ja, dan ga je hem echt mooi zien, hè. Je ziet echt die curve helemaal fantastisch hier zo. Dat is een probleem.
There's the other problem of the blade hitting the wood. We also saw this with the other blades. So we have two problems, the tilting and the blades hitting the wood. We agreed on trying it anyway to see what happens.
Het ergste is dat er een hapje uit het hout gaat.
Oké, 3, 2, 1.
Ik denk dat deze wel leuker is op de high speed.
Zomaar? Ja, we gaan hem even bekijken.
Oh ja, hij gaat echt heel scheef.
Ja.
With this blade we could really see the tilting problem.
Hij raakte weer hout.
Ja.
After a second attempt, it was hitting the wood again.
Ja, shit, wat doen we daarmee?
Ja, ik zeg spanbandje erom.
I suggested using a ratchet strap to place the beams close together so it wouldn't tilt and hopefully fall within that slit, but... We decided to call it a day, but now we have this guillotine standing there and no clue of what to do with it.
Hmm. Ik denk dat dit het wel is.
Ja.
Wil je nog een stukje?
Ja, lekker. Dat lijkt me wel lekker.
So we ended up discussing the possible improvements, and one of them is to make the rails better. I'm thinking about using these rollers and have them guide along a tube, so it runs much smoother and it's also possible to align the tubes. And maybe combine it with a timing belt on the opposite ends, so a bit like a 3D printer where the gantry doesn't tilt. With those coupled timing belts. Anyway, the question that we were left with is, wouldn't this also be the case for the original guillotines? Yes, they are made out of much thicker wood that doesn't flex, But there is still that tilting force that causes losses. Wouldn't the straight blade have been better after all?